NFL on EA Sports. And we'll be watching the Huskies' sure-handed wide receiver. No one's been busier this season as he currently paces the NFL in receptions. It's the Huskies and the Broncos, and it's coming up next.
We find ourselves at the foot of the Rockies, Denver, Colorado, for this edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Today we hit double digits, week 10, and we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Huskies of Rio de Janeiro taking on the Denver Broncos. And hello again, everyone. Brandon Gauden alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, we look at this Bronco team. They come in off a loss last time out, but they've been playing better than 500 ball the last couple months. Five wins in their last eight games.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Cariocas,
they've gone a full half season since their last loss, winners of eight in a row.
And you don't get on win streaks like this without your defense playing a big role. They've created quite an identity, and I know they want and expect this streak to get to nine.
The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports.
No run back here on the opening kickoff, as we'll start at the 25.
So here are the Broncos now for their opening drive. And they will be led out by a man in his sophomore campaign as the quarterback.
And last week's loss came despite a clean game on his end, throwing the ball with two touchdowns and zero interceptions. His job this week is simple. Do it again. Continue to avoid turnovers and hope that what sunk them last week resolves itself this time around.
A little bit of daylight on that first down run sets him up nicely. 8 yards on the carry. A check on Jacobs from a week ago. 14 carries, 63 yards.
When a winning streak stretches this far, you start to wonder if a team is truly unstoppable. And here's a guy who's been very much the legs that have helped drive this team to wins week after week. And even when teams have keyed on him and tried to slow him down, he's still gotten the job done enough to avoid a loss. Talking to the pregame, though, he thinks that this week could be his biggest week yet.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Running straight ahead is Jacobs, taken down at the 42. But you look at this defense. They enter this one down in the 26th position in the NFL against the run.
For some defensive fronts, playing the run is not the priority. It's playing the pass, right? They get upfield, they rush the passer, and sometimes neglect stopping the run. That's something that they have to work on to reverse a little bit. Make sure you play the run on your way back to the quarterback.
They'll need five on this play to move the sticks.
From the gun on third down, Swift.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have the Broncos' first down. They needed five there on third down. He winds up getting seven.
Back to the running game with Jacobs. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48.
From the 48-yard line, here's the second and nine.
Brings up second and nine at the 48-yard line.
They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. And he picks up about six as he gets this down to the 41. With that run, double check my math, yes, he has hit 8,000 career rushing yards.
And that's fantastic. That means he's now approaching the top 50 all-time rushers in NFL history. That means he just sped past Terrell Davis, who's in the Hall of Fame. And now he's just got to go ahead and be strong and run hard because he's chasing down Larry Zonka.
They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And he'll be taken down at the 34. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Good boy. Got step over.
Off play action. Swift. And incomplete on the deep ball.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down. And he missed it. He missed it just wide of that.
Let's go.
It's no good. And this will remain a scoreless game.
I'm about to say something that seems really obvious, but you hate to see your kicker miss on the opening drive because now you're starting to wonder what goes through his head. Is that going to affect him the rest of the game? Is he going to be able to bounce back? You want to show confidence later? What's going to go on with him right out of the gate with a miss?
Yeah, a chance to grab the 3-0 lead here at home. Instead, we remain scoreless. That's caught by Howard, and he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That's a good way to start the drive, 17 yards and a first down. Back to throw, pull, middle of the field, it's Robinson. It'll go as a gain of four, and it'll be second down. A nice opening right away as he'll maneuver his way up to the 32-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
That's a very nice game there. Confidence-building run. Love the execution up front. And the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
Let's go.
Right side, he hauls it in. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. First and 10. Pool. This is caught. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Another first down as he went right back to the same well, this time for 17 yards.
Just picking up yardage.
Quarterback is heating right now.
Plays. They have moved right down the field. And just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
Here we go now on first and goal. They'll try to run this one in, and he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down, so let's see what this is about.
Oh, come on. Pick a touchdown away.
So reverse the celebration. We'll see if they have something else in their bag of tricks.
And isn't that always tough to watch when they score and you see the excitement, and then when they realize those points aren't going to count? Can they get it back together and find their way back to the end zone?
Throw left side complete. That's Parker. And give him a full 10 yards there. Second and goal.
A 10-yard pickup. It's second and goal at the 3-yard line.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And it's caught. Touchdown. A great effort there. With touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Huskies are on the board first here this afternoon.
It's Stafford's.
Well, these guys have won 3 straight ball games and another good start to this one out to the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood of a team and how much easier it is to actually prepare during that time. Guys are sharp, guys are focused, everyone's feeling good, and we're seeing it early in this one.
Elliott good with a PAT, and it's now a 7-0 game. And no run back here for Slayton, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. So now the second drive offensively coming up for the Denver Broncos. And the way their last drive ended, boy, it was frustrating. They had a pretty good drive going. It was sustained, and then it stalled out, Charles, and they missed the field goal and got nothing out of it.
Is that insult to injury? Because they had such a sustained drive, as you noted. So you know for the head coach, it almost felt like a little bit of failure to send out the field goal unit and then to not even see the ball go through the post. What a bummer on that last drive for them. Got to pick themselves up from that one.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. Second down and 8. Off the play fake. Swift. Open man. He's got Jefferson across the formation. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
Kind of a dangerous throw there. He's off balance when he gets rid of it. But this is all about a quarterback knowing what he can get away with. And that time, it turns into a completion and a healthy gain as well.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive.
What up, John? How are you? The A1 right now.
Carry, it's Kamara. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
I think it jinxed your team, though. After I showed you that picture of them being 6-1, they lost twice in a row.
They go back to the ground, this time Jacobs. And he'll go down at the 28. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
On first down, they go with Jacobs again. And a hard working run here as he's got it inside the 20, down to the 17. That one going for a gain of 11, and a Bronco first down. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't
we? I think they did
it. Arrogance now, and that's
I gotta check
arrogance,
again.
Believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. They'll give to Kamara here on the option. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. And it looks like a pickup of 6. That leaves him with 7 yards to go on third down.
Have you been paying attention in real life? Have you been paying attention to the free agency?
That is incomplete.
Just looking at it from a defensive perspective, when you break the huddle in the red zone, tight end is one of the guys you've got a key on because quarterbacks want the ball in their hands fast in this position, and they want to get it to someone. And in this case, he had the play. They just didn't complete it.
So they were able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell us end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal you'll take, punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
The offense now at the line, ready
for the Ravens. We signed Christian Wilkins, so now we have a defensive. Let's go. We have a defensive line now. We also signed Gardner Minshew.
If it ended today, and I guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room and their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So Josh Jacobs went to the Packers.
Ready for the second quarter, and it's our visitors with the football.
What else?
They've got it in the first and 10.
That was pretty much it.
That's for a right sideline here.
In terms of like the Raiders, a defensive tackle. Defensive tackle, yeah.
Here now, second and 4. Off play action. Pull. Over the middle, complete. It's Robinson. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Again, he'll drop to throw.
Oof. Yeah, we got to be careful with that.
That was well played, but that was also an example of a corner who understands his coverage, realized he had support behind him, and could be a little more aggressive in the shorter zone.
Yeah, Roger the Feeler.
Exactly that.
The Saints is looking at trying to get Chase Young.
At the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Here's 3rd and 10.
Oh, yeah, wide receiver got cut. I forget his name. The one that had beef with Derek Carr.
That is incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. Charles, even as long field goals become more and more common, this is still very rarefied air. Only just over 20 field goals have been kicked from 60 yards or further, and you can add his name to the list now.
And as calm as he tried to present himself, There's no doubt there were some nerves as he lined up to attempt that kick. But once the ball was snapped, he just swept the leg and boom, over the crossbar.
And today, I don't think anything like huge happened, or at least people that I would recognize.
They go play action here on first down. So, they'll get this out to Kamara.
Everything big happened on the first day.
So 5 yards here, five on the play. And that's going to bring up...
You're going to try out the play for the Saints?
Shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Looking to throw on second down. Swift.
Looking for... Let's go.
That's intercepted. And they have possession. And they have...
That's his first... That's the rookie. That's his first interception all season.
CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, ah, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember...
That's true.
On the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise.
But can you control your dislike of Derek Carter?
To take over. And they'll have good field position here following the interception and a chance to build on their lead as they start with a first and 10.
As you know, he's the man in New Orleans now.
Pretty solid run here on first down. Almost picked up another first, but he appears to be a few inches short.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there.
He's carving them up. Let's go.
Earlier, this one's going to get him a first down. Looking to throw. Poole firing quickly, but it's incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes.
He loved calling that play. That play never worked.
A pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
To throw on second down. Pool. It's caught on the right side.
He never worked.
So back to back plays, each get nothing. And this brings up a third and goal. They'll look to throw again.
Ooh, too much. He did too much on that.
He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
Because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now drive has started with great field position. It's facing fourth down.
The Giants, the Panthers, they did the craziest thing I've ever seen. They traded to the Giants Brian Burns. He's like a 25-year-old edge rusher.
And what a luxury it is.
Like one of the better. Put in Geno Smith. Nah, I'm good. I think I'm okay.
And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
Brian Burns, he's like a 25-year-old, like, superstar edge rusher. The Panthers traded him to the Giants for a second-round pick and a first round and a fifth-round pick when they could have gotten two first rounds for him.
If you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is one. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
2 yards the loss, second and 12. Back to throw. Swift as this complete to Woods.
Like literally, the moment he agreed to sign with the Giants, they gave him $100 million contract.
Kamara up the middle. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. Here's second and 10. Play fake. Swift. And his throw is incomplete.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field is popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense because there's usually a great amount of bodies.
Why, you don't like part of the... You wanted Kirk Cousins?
In this case, no one came up with it.
He's got his target. That's complete. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards.
You wanted Kirk Cousins on the Saints?
This has become routine, hasn't it? That was a heck of a route there by the tight end. A great double move for a big-time catch downfield.
Oh.
This offense finding.
Well, the good thing is you only had to see him twice.
First and 10. Off play action. Swift. This pass to Jennings and he makes a catch. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Back to back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
You can still go to the Super Bowl with two losses.
Jacob's going to try the middle to about the 26 here.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. 54 yards rushing for him now. What was his 10th carry of the ball game?
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him.
Killing us on the ground.
The middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Josh Jacobs with career touchdown number 70. And the Broncos have cut it back within a score. Some good running there at the end of the drive. He had the burst that set up the first and goal, and then one play later, he's in the end zone.
Brandon, what I liked about that sequence is, I'm not sure who made the play call, but they understood the situation, understood the momentum. A nice hard-charging run, give it right back to him, and let him cap things off.
Extra
play. Yeah, right, my offensive line, I don't understand why my offensive line gives up runs like that. But
comes a return.
Every game is like a shootout.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Now the Rio offense set to take over. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But you also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
There, they'll keep leaning on the running.
Let's go.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Hands it off out of the gun. And he slips up past the...
My quarterback is the second. This is his second year in the league. My wide receiver is... This is his first year in the league. He's still a rookie. And my running back is... This is his first year in the league. My quarterback is an X factor. And my wide receiver is an X factor.
To him after a gain of 6 to the 46. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 15 yards there on the catch and run.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
What's up, Art? I appreciate the alert.
First down, pull. This is Smith to the ground. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts.
As just watching the Huskies dominate.
Next. Touchdown. Allen Robinson from 4 yards out. And they are able to add on to their advantage. What a great drive that was. A long drive, sustained, well executed.
I love what we're seeing out of him here in year two, right? This young quarterback continues to evolve and grow. He's really the adage right now that John Wooden, the famous basketball coach, used to say. Be quick, but don't hurry. You can see that everything is happening for him, but he's not taking it at a pace that he can't sustain.
Elliott good on the extra point.
these guys will take a 10-point lead.
Your brother's a fan of the Broncos?
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. Here comes the offense again, and let's focus on Josh Jacobs for a moment. They're behind in the first half here, CD, but it's not through any fault of their running back. He's had a strong...
I feel sorry for him, because we be beating him up in real life, the Raiders.
You would think that his team is in the lead. He has been a lot of fun in this contest. Now let's see if they can actually make something happen, put more points on the board behind his efforts.
Yeah, I'm curious to see, Charles, if they can play complementary football and get that passing game going as well. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
Give him credit for excellent coverage, tight coverage. They're doing a lot of things that we talk about in basketball. They're causing disruptions in the passing game. And as long as that continues, it'll be tough for them to gain any momentum throwing the ball downfield.
The call for a fair catch, and it's made at about the 23-yard line.
So oh, the Raiders have been beating the Broncos. I think the last time they defeated us was like, I want to say like 2018, 2017. A catch.
They'll tell you, I had no idea how many yards I had. Those guys have an innate sense of where they are in a ball game and how many yards they've accumulated.
Get down.
Always working towards 100.
My quarterback's like Michael Vick. He fumbles all the time.
Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
Apparently. That's the way we like it, though.
Looking to throw. Pull. He's got his running back out of the backfield. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
Holding. Offense.
Nah, it's just more interesting. It's just more interesting when... And when you have people with different favorite teams.
Back to throw. Pull. Able to find the open man.
If everybody liked the same team, that's boring.
Called for by the offense as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here in this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops, and escape this drive.
It's caught inside the 25. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it...
He's trying. Let's get the touchdown.
Speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas. They're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Well, it looked like a march to the end zone. Is it a momentary...
I don't know where you get the notion that I'm a villain.
They just got to come up with a high
percentage. You shouldn't be spreading narratives like that. That's not nice.
Taking it about the one. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And they'll have time for one play. There's 2 seconds on the clock. this throw incomplete, and that is how this first half will come to an end. So we've reached the intermission in what right now is a 13-point game. As now we send you out to Orlando and hook back up with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. More from you two in a minute, but first, let's take a spin around the NFL and see what's going on here in week number 10. We'll get started up at FedEx Field in our nation's capital, where was the home team who were able to hold serve and get a victory in their stadium. Elijah Mitchell, what a game. 3 touchdown runs in the victory. From there, let's make the quick trip up the parkway and check in on the Ravens at home in Baltimore. And it's the visiting Jets who have the lead in that one. Kirk Cousins has fired 3 touchdown passes. Finally, let's get to Silicon Valley to check on the 49ers at home at Levi Stadium. As you can see, the score there in the second quarter. The 49ers locked in a tight one, but this is a game you feel they've got to have.
The 49ers is 1-7.
To watch so far. We knew this was going to be a battle, and we have not been disappointed. This is the kind of game that could wind up hinging on which side can play mistake-free football the rest of the way.
All right, Coach, thank you very much as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. So the halftime break behind us, and we are back underway with a third quarter of action. This taken in right around the goal line. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. This offense ready to go to begin this third quarter.
Let's go.
They'll start on the ground here on first down. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. A gain of 9.
Now that's a run that warms a play caller's heart, because you're actually set up to do whatever you want on offense. You can come right back and run essentially the same play because you have momentum. Or you can fake that running play and throw something deep over the top. Or you now feel like you have an extra down to play with, because if you go ahead and just throw it and you don't get it, come back and try and pick it up on third down.
On first down, they'll run it on the draw play. And they see right through that defensive as he'll be hit and taken down in the backfield. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
And that's what this defense is going to need to do more in the second half. Good pressure that time, forces some indecision in the backfield, and he's going to wind up being taken down for a nice loss.
Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain. Tough spot here. Third down and 11. Operating from the gun. Pull.
Let's go.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down, that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think the defense fell asleep at the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball out of his hands.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6. So from the 26-yard line, here's second and 4. Back to throw again. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they just keep marching right along. First down on a pickup of 8 there. Looking to throw. Pull. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Parker. So he stopped for no gain. And it's second down. Back to throw. Pull. He finds Robinson. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. Third down and 10. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Over the middle, it's complete. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And I'll tell you what, this offense is playing a little bit of keep away right now. They've come out here in the third quarter, possessed the ball for quite a while, and they keep on converting. Nice pitch and catch there to set up the first and goal.
Operating from the gun. Pull. It's caught on the right side. It's Smith. So that'll be no better than an incompletion, and it'll bring up a second and goal. They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. Looking to throw. Poole. And it's caught. Touchdown. Devontae Parker. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Huskies take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical. That's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
And he's going to be taken down. It's a sack. And they fail.
I think we should have took the points there personally.
They tried to get two and ended up getting none. Because the quarterback had nowhere to go with the ball and ends up getting sacked.
Nowhere to go at all. Great job, though, defensively. They were ready. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And good starting field position.
His last possible version for him. That's crazy.
35-yard line. So now a look at the Broncos as they head back out there for their first possession of the second half. Good starting position for the Broncos here as they come up first and 10 at their 35-yard line. Middle of the field to Jefferson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
Oh, that's a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go.
Open it, let's go.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Jennings. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Bronco first down.
Oh, that was a nice job there. Quarterback and receiver reading the pressure that was brought. They both knew it was going to open up the middle of the field. Nice little shake and bake in the line of scrimmage, got right into his route, and the quarterback hit him in stride, and he was able to run free after the catch.
Now a play fake here on first down. Nowhere to go.
Oh, nice fumble. And he got a safety. Let's go.
Out of the back of the end zone, so that is going to be a safety. Oh, my. All I can say is that that baby might have just set the game of football back 40 years. Maybe 50, maybe 60.
Let's just go 100. For 70. Just keep going.
The game never started.
Because there's no way I can analyze that. There's just no way.
And remember, following the safety, you give
it. That was well, right?
And they free kick it from the 20 now. Now it's Haney.
I'm glad that I'm recording so that you can see I'm not making this up.
Number 20 on that last drive. And they start here with a first down. Throwing on first down. Poole, short pass to Howard. So give him 2 yards there on the completion, and that'll make it second down.
Brings up second and 8 at the 32-yard line.
Back to throw. Poole, he'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. They get 7 there on the screen. It'll set up a third down.
That's a nice design there, but sometimes, though, you get so many blockers out ahead of you, they kind of slow you down and force you to adjust. You always appreciate guys trying to help you, but maybe one less there could have turned this into a bigger game.
They'll roll him out right.
Let's go. He's learning to slide.
He does have the first down.
The quarterback is used to just taking attacks and then fumbling the ball.
First and 10. Poole steps away to his left.
Let's go.
And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Ball start. Offense.
This O-line's been great. They've got the big lead, so give them a pass there, I guess.
Yeah, I would think so, because if we were grading them on their performance in this game, a lot of pluses in their boxes so far.
Looking to throw. Pull.
Ooh. If he could have got that up a little bit further, that would have been out of, he'd been out of here.
Precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's a perfect word for it, precise, because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
Give him 9 yards on the second down screen play. The line to gain is the 33 on third down. Operating from the gun. Pull to the right side. He's got Parker. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. On first down, Poole. And this one complete to Smith. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch.
He gets all the wide receivers, all the pass catches involved.
Now he'll try to run with this.
See, I told you, he always fumbles.
And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. He let one slip away last week as well, so now two fumbles lost in as many weeks.
Well, we were out at practice, and we watched him work. And what did his
he always fumbles. That's why he needs to slide more.
Oh, I get it. Two-hand monster. Both hands on the football. Taking care of it, putting it away so the ball doesn't get dropped.
Following the fumble recovery, Swift. And his throw here is incomplete.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, he has broken.
First down, got his hand in and knocked it away.
Second and 10 now. Third quarter action in Denver. Off the play fake. Swift. Out route to Jefferson, and he's got it.
This is Madden, so I wouldn't doubt it.
Being tackled. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back now to Denver. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Another nice gain, 16 yards there and a first down again. A three-score game here late. You could probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league, a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count as a moral victory or boys.
This man got negative 53 yards running
down to just two scores
because of that safety.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield incomplete. Now a second and 10. Throwing again. Swift. Justin Jefferson bringing in the slant. The offense on third down, they've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 4.
Let's go.
But that's going to wind up incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they've forced in this runaway contest.
Got a man, that's Hamler, and he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Well, those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first three quarters, and this deficit going to be tough to overcome here in the fourth, but a nice first down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where his coaches, you're looking for effort and execution, even though the scoreboard is going against you. You want to find out who's going to fight, who's going to scrap, who's going to keep their heads up and continue to play.
Second and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
They'll get this out to Kamara.
They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of four. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Again, he'll drop to throw. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down.
He's making a comeback, negative 44.
Back to throw. Swift.
Oh, that was nice. That was nice throw.
Have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still two scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you'd kept them at the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
The extra point up and good, and the lead will be cut down to 14. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. Now the Rio offense set to take over. They've got the two-score lead. Look, though, they fumbled last possession, led to a touchdown. So while things look good here at this stage in the fourth, they got to be careful.
They definitely do, because they've actually brought them back into it, haven't they? They've given them hope once again. Their purpose on this drive, squash that hope one more time.
This second and four. Shot here on the ground.
Let's go.
We
need to get 14 yards so we can get that 100-yard game.
Rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And showcasing those strong legs on that run, getting through one tackle. Now she winds up getting eight there. 2 yards to go, second down. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping.
Let's go.
And that'll be a free 5 yards for the offense.
Just like a tennis match, that's just an unforced error. Stay alert, don't jump early, and give them free yardage.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. And he'll run on the inside handoff. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. A run here for J.D. McKissic. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there. And now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. Looking to throw. Pull. Hard throw. Incomplete.
Dropped it.
But plain and simple, that's the second time today that he's dropped a pass.
And that one, I think, maybe even a little easier than the earlier one that he dropped, surprising.
Was this game announced as a night game prior to it? Maybe his rhythm was just off. He's got thrown off. He's got to wake up, enjoy the sunshine, and go play.
So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a three-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
But you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, two scores is tough enough. Three, I'm with you. That seems out of the question.
Slayton going to take it from the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. And Denver getting set to take the field. And you see a lot of frustrated faces as they are inching closer to a fourth straight loss. Throwing on first down, Swift. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. Back to throw. Swift. He'll swing that out wide to Jacobs. They're going to hurry back to the line now. On third down, Swift. And that is incomplete.
How about the coverage we just saw him break out on third down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
Able to get away. And brought down, but not before he was able to break.
Oh no, my safety's injured.
And now it looks like we're going to get a timeout.
Hopefully he's not out for too long.
Shaken up. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Looking to throw. Swift. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. Ball at the 40 here for second and 5. Operating from the gun. Swift. That'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down. Operating from the gun. Swift. He's got his target. That's complete. And he will have a Broncos first down by about 3 yards or so as they wind up getting 7 there on third and 4.
Let's go.
Nick Needham picks it off. And they are going to set up shop.
The backup. The backup got an interception.
Offensively, Charles, hard to put a silver lining on this one. No secret that they had to take chances with a score where it is, and it leads to a turnover.
I love how you paint the picture, partner, because you're exactly right about that one. Look at the empty stares on that sideline. This is one of those games where you just want to go crawl under a rock until it's over.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. Good gain there on first down and keeps him in a running situation probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front, good blocking, nice hole for him. Ends up picking up nice yardage, stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
Not in any rush offensively. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. He'll get this out to Barkley complete. They call his number again. It's his 6th catch and a first down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's our visitors with a football as we get you reset. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. And they run the option here on first and 10. And maybe the wrong read there as he's going to go down immediately. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play. They'll have to deal with a second and 14 now after the loss. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 115 yards rushing for him now to this point. This now a 3rd and 4.
Let's get this first down and end the game.
Operating from the gun. Pool. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And he is out of bounds. But
I'm still throwing it, though. That's just disrespectful.
Call his number again. It's his 6th catch and a first down. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
They'll run on first down with Dallas. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down 4th quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it at them. We've got them now.
So this crowd will not go home happy. It's a victory for our visitors, and maybe more importantly, a victory in the division, which always helps.
And on the road, how about all of that rolled up into one? Because how often do you see division games get decided by this much of a margin?
Yeah, they thumped them.
Yeah, they jumped all over them. And a division game is usually a touchdown or less because these two teams know each other better than most teams in the league. In this case, that didn't hold up. On the road, big margin, big victory. Oh, yeah, that flight home will be good.
So for Rio, the great run they've been on continues as they move to 9-1 now. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Broncos, it's a loss that'll drop them back to 500 through 10 games. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden.
Oh my God, he's gone for 3 weeks. But Malcolm Kuntz coming back next week, so our defensive line is set. Darryl Bailey. I don't think we need a strong safety, but I'll put him on the list. Don't even have a first round pick. David Poole is unstoppable right now. Let's give him a little bit of a challenge. Why would we want to look at him? All right. Oh, we gotta do focus. Oh, okay. We don't want to come back, so I'm not going to try to force any backup.
It's Madden NFL 24 on EA Sports, and we'll be watching the Huskies, burner at wide receiver. Always staying busy, he's your league leader in receiving yards. It's the Huskies and the
Giants. Came into the league and set the league on fire.
Next on Madden Football.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us in South America in the vibrant and colorful Brazilian beachside city of Rio de Janeiro. Today we've got an interesting Week 11 matchup on tap as it'll be the New York Giants taking on the Huskies of Rio de Janeiro. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Rio de Janeiro team. They've been flawless these last couple months, winners of 9 in a row.
And that's the kind of streak you don't see too often in today's NFL since there's so much parity. So the way they've played has been truly remarkable.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Giants, they too were winners last time out. So something's got to give here.
I love it when both teams come in off of wins. Great mindsets, and it usually leads to a really well-played game.
Season has hit high gear, and off we go in week 11 on EA Sports.
Taking it about the one. And able to get this out to the 25.
So here are the Giants ready to start their initial drive of the game.
They're led by the number one overall pick in the 2021 draft, Trevor Lawrence.
The word is potential, potential, potential. Think about this guy from the
top. Let's see if we can put some pressure on him.
One of the top prospects going to college, coming out of college, mentioned as a generational type quarterback. He looks the part. Tall, big arm, surveys the field, and can take off and run when under duress.
Lawrence, and that's going to be incomplete.
Oh, Amari Cooper couldn't pull it in there. Second down.
That's definitely Amari Cooper.
Against the pass, just numbers that they haven't liked. Number 30 in the league right now.
You know, when actors get ready for a scene, they often ask the question, what's my motivation? But what's the motivation of this group?
They tried to run RPO with Hunter Renfrow. You nuts? What?
A bit of a jump there, CD. He breaks the line, and that'll be 5 yards.
And you've got to stay more disciplined than that, Brandon. That's just a free gift to the offense.
And they still need 6 yards here on third down after the penalty. So the offense, a little antsy. The flag comes out, and a 5-yard penalty.
That's right. Give us our 5 yards back.
So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long. Now Lawrence.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift,
and they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. The numbers for him from a week ago, 23 carries, 82 yards.
Yeah, he could very well be on his way to a rushing title, but guess what? His offensive line, they're meeting separately because they want that rushing title as much as he does, and they want to make sure they get him there.
Now whistles here and a flag down. I think a Giant jumped early. They were looking good on second down, but now they're backed up 5 yards by the false start, and it's second and 8.
Now Lawrence to throw. Short throw caught by Pitts.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
And we gotta stop this.
First and 10 at Swift.
And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
This is Swift on the counter.
Let's go.
The yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first.
They'll try and pick it up with Mitchell, and he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only they're controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield. blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. A big play that time on the catch and run, and it'll move the chains.
Lawrence is doing pretty well. I can't even hold it.
Shown on this opening drive, they've been methodical, they've been crisp, and as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Swift diving for the end zone, and he is in.
Untouched.
And that caps off what was really a balanced opening drive for them, Charles. They work in the rushing game and the aerial attack, and they end it with a touchdown.
Strong in so many ways, wasn't it, partner? Their ability to throw it and run it and accomplish their goal, they've got to like the way that they started this ball game.
And his kick is no good.
He missed it. Oh, my God. He missed extra one.
This one stays a 6-0 game. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. And a look at a guy, definitely got a little razzle-dazzle to him. Can do it with his arm or his legs, their mobile QB.
And he's certainly putting together an MVP-type season, leading the league in both passing yards and touchdown passes. There have not been too many defenses have been able to stop him or even slow him down. So he's got his sights set on another big game right here.
And the throw here called by Devontae Parker. That'll go for a gain of 7, and it's second down.
Brandon, to me, what's important right here on this drive is for them to get at least 2 first downs. They've got to give their defense a chance to settle down, catch their breath a little bit after they give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. A gain of 13, it's a first down. Back to throw. Pull.
Dropped it.
Second down. You talk about this giant defense. And they find themselves just outside the top 10 in the league against the pass, currently bringing up the number 11 spot.
Yeah, this has been a good defense, but they're going to have to really prove it in this one because guess what? They're facing the number 1 passing offense in the NFL. It's definitely a prove it day for them.
To throw on third down.
Pace.
Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It's a gain of 8, and it'll wind up moving the chains.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
On first and 10.
I dropped it again. You gotta hold on to those.
Looking to throw. Pull. Now they go screen. It's complete.
And go.
They're gonna have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants 28. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because Brandon. When guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get
oh my God, what's with these drop passes?
Use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
They'll look to throw again. Smith. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4. Now a 3rd and 6. Back to throw. Pull. Quick throw to Barkley. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants 14. Give them 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful of one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now you're right. They're in man-to-man. Maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Oh, he dropped it.
Zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Back to throw again. Buying time to his left. They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down.
So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage.
On third down, Poole.
Let's go.
Touchdown. A great play there. His 9th touchdown of the season. And the Huskies are an extra point away now from moving out in front. Well, Charles, he's still a young signal caller in this league, second year in the NFL. But I don't know if last year as a rookie if he would have worked through his progressions like he did on that touchdown pass.
I think you're right about that. We're seeing him grow up right in front of our eyes because when he went to his primary read, he recognized that they were all over that. So he continued to survey the field, picked up another target, delivered a pass exactly where it needed to be. A very mature play for the second-year quarterback.
And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
So the Giants getting the football back here for their second drive.
They currently sit one game over 500 thanks to their victory a week ago. But, Charles, they've been really an up-and-down team all year. Do you think that they have enough to get into the playoffs?
Well, you did mention they've been up and down all year, so to me,
come on, you got to stop that.
When they're at their best, I
think they're going to get some pressure. Got to get him running around or something.
They've been able to bring the intensity week in and week out, and that could be their Achilles heel.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Here's Lawrence to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
How about that? Red man coverage and decided to test him early. But it proved up to the task and forced the incompletion.
Here's Lawrence. The open man here, Renfrow.
And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
They'll try and run here with Swift.
And he's got the first down before being taken down at the 46. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
First down, and they go with Swift again.
And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's second down.
Well, this defense, very strong in that victory from a week ago.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football.
Let's go. That's what we need to do. We were running around.
Especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
On third down, Lawrence.
And he lost the football.
Let's go.
Lineman on the other side has got it.
And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
We know he's got the speed to get downfield, Charles, but there's the negative side. A little loose with the football that time.
And that's normal, especially when you have his type of talents, because you feel like you're into the open field, and maybe you don't feel the people who are around you or closing in.
I know how that feels.
Have to do extra ball security drills with the way the game's played now, because defenses, they attack the football as much as they attack the runner.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. They'll look to throw for it on third.
Oh, he dropped it again. What is happening?
If he had caught it, it would have been a first down. Instead, it's fourth.
And that is how you respond after taking one on the chin to begin this game. Give up a first drive touchdown, go back out on defense, and completely shut them down to force a 3 and out.
And they'll let this one go right on the outskirts of the 10. They'll down it at the 11-yard line.
Yeah, we got to start turning
the Giants at the line, ready to begin their next drive. On play action, Lawrence.
Let's go.
Go down. They sack him on the final play of the first quarter. After one, a one-point game, 7-6. Giant football, and we're ready to begin the second quarter. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Now Lawrence.
Ooh.
And that will be incomplete. Try to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
I'm nervous about that.
Lawrence will throw. A quick throw there is incomplete.
Nice call by the defense there on third down. Just flood the field with extra defensive backs in their dime package. Nowhere to go with the football. Forces the incompletion.
The punt team on now is from their end zone. They get it away. Oh, able to avoid him. And 8-yard return there after a punt of 47. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. The Rio offense about to set up shop once again. No points last time out. They were forced to punt, if you remember, but no time to dwell on that. They've still got the lead here and a chance to add to that here. First and 10 as this new drive starts. 11 yards for number 11. On first down, Poole.
Ooh, almost.
Bats it away and it falls down.
That was a good shot, though.
You've always been very good about checking my math. Am I correct? That's the first time that it's been incomplete when they've thrown it to him?
Yes, he had caught every other ball coming his way.
So they feel like they've got something really good going there, and they're going to continue to go there until the defense makes an adjustment and takes it away.
Well, they finally made an adjustment there. We'll see if they can build on that stop. From the gun on third down.
Oh, my God. He's dropping passes.
Complete the contact there. Jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
Sometimes the game is pretty simple. Put a few extra defensive backs on the field, give them nowhere to throw the football, force the incompletion, and get off the field on third down.
The kick by Elliott is good, and they bump the lead up to four now at 10-6. Well, a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the three.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
Back on offense, New York gets set to take over. And you know, there's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good, and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you all those early shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, and I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
Lawrence. And this is going to be
it's goal.
I'll tell you what, these last couple of drives, much better from a defensive perspective. They gave him a touchdown on the opening drive, and then after forcing a punt on their last possession, it looks like they're going to get the football back.
Yeah, the Saints are 7-3.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And they will take over first and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Poole firing quickly here, and that's complete. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage.
Oh, my goodness.
Offense.
All right, so they got that one, Charles, against the center.
And let's remember how difficult it is for the center, because remember, he's got to snap the ball to put the play in motion, and sometimes you got that big guy on your nose, you got sometimes where he's coming at you at an angle. It's a difficult job for him to snap the ball and then execute his block.
And this offense on third down today, they've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. And he is caught, and he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. They get 5 out of that one, and he moves the chains. Gotta say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage, so they're going to throw the football more time.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's
and it's Williams.
Down. Leonard Williams, able to record his 5th sack of the season.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. Ooh. That play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted.
The defense is putting in work. I ain't even going to hold you.
It's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up 3rd down. Operating from the gun. Pool. This is caught by Robinson. He'll get 17 back there, but it'll still lead to a 4th down.
I don't know how many times, not just in my playing career, but you and I working together, have we ever heard a coach say, you know, I just don't have that play on my call sheet. And that's really what we had here. That was a big hole they were trying to get out of.
Yeah, big gain, still a ways to go, though. And no return here. This one's going inside the 15 to the 12-yard line. And New York set to take the field. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Let's go.
Pass play there, but it's incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They're giving him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
And now the 3rd down throw incomplete as well.
Yeah, that's a nice job there defensively to blank those receivers on 3rd down, and as a quarterback, can do is just lock one toward the bench, not too close, mind you, and live to punt the football.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And taken right at the 35. Call it a 48-yard punt. Give him 9, though, on the return. Now the Rio offense set to take over. Obviously not the intended goal last drive. They had to punt the football, but still, they've got the lead here and now a chance to add on to that lead. If they can get points on this drive.
Come on with the drop passes.
Throwing on 1st down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So after the incompletion on 1st, now
he's dominating if they hold on to the ball.
Looking to throw. Pull. And he fires one incomplete.
Tough series.
This is a sloppy game.
Things just aren't clicking. Hoping they can come through on this play and get this series back on track with a completion for enough yardage for a 1st down.
Ooh. A heavy rush, and down he goes. T.J. Watt drops him for a loss of 10, and it's going to be 4th and long.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. 3rd and long, why are you calling play action?
Yeah, because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to deal with pass protection and their line blocking. But to me, it seems silly.
Yeah, well, they're silly, and it leads to a play-action sack.
Yeah, I agree with you. That finally makes sense.
4th down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Taking it about the 16. It'll be a 47-yard punt with a net of 40 following a 7-yard return. And it'll be Giant football 1st and 10. On the ground, it's Swift to start the drive.
He'll
be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6.
So if you've been playing defense in this one, there's a little bit of the good
and some bad, because they did give up the touchdown run to him earlier, but shut him down otherwise.
Outside of that, you're exactly right. I would say they've contained him very well. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On third and one, it's Lawrence. He's got a man open. It's Hunter Renfro. And he goes out of bounds. Just
I'm getting cooked by Hunter Renfro. This is crazy.
It's an 11-yard pickup. Thought they'd run it on third and one. Not the case.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
They run out of the gun.
Here we go.
And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Defensively, he has been a presence in their backfield in the first half. Had a sack earlier, and now he comes up with a big tackle for a loss.
Play action. It's Lawrence. He's got Mason complete.
Oh, my God. That was a good play action.
There on the catch and run.
Well, this has certainly been a nice drive with the way they've spread the football around. Here, they even get the fullback involved in the passing game. That's got to cause a lot of consternation on the defensive side. You've got to cover him, too. That makes things really difficult.
Well, he'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Here's second and 3. Looking to throw, Lawrence.
Nice.
And his throw is going to be incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play. One that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
Lawrence on third down.
Let's go.
It's incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. The offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out. They'll try it now with Swift.
Oh, come on, we got a tackle.
And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it, but in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. Now Lawrence on first down. Oh, oh. Man, that's Renfro. Touchdown, Giants.
I'm getting cooked by Hunter Renfro. This is crazy.
A 20-yard touchdown. And the Giants are once again back in front. And that is off the left.
He missed again? That's crazy.
Offensively, defense looked a little confused, but he found his receiver, and that went good for 6 points.
And the payoff we just saw there tells us how many times they ran this play in practice over the past few weeks, because they executed that flawlessly right here on game day when the situation arose.
Well, the Rio offense about to set up shop once again. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offense.
Oh, my God.
And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he'll be out of bounds right around the 14. It'll be a game. I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. This time they stay on the ground. And they'll indeed stop him.
I'm going to try to run with third and 19.
With your timeouts. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as it comes to 22 seconds to go here in half number one. Let's take it inside his own 40. A nice job getting free on the return for 13 yards. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half.
Ball start. Offense.
The false start backs him up 5, first and 15. Now Lawrence. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurt.
Let's go.
Gets to Lawrence, and he'll go down. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
That could be the stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here in the first half. After that possession, now they know that they can compete with this offense.
Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. This is taken at the 15. So we come upon halftime here with the visiting Giants out on top. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report.
He's playing abysmal.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. The NFL season is going to be about two-thirds complete after this weekend. So lots to get to as we check out what's going on here in Week 11. We'll start up at MetLife Stadium in New Jersey. And it's the Jets who have the lead in the second quarter.
Kirk Cousins
has fired 3 touchdown passes. From there, we'll head down to Charlotte to check on the Panthers at home at Bank of America Stadium. And you can see they have the lead over the visiting Tennessee Titans. 3 Tua Tagovailoa touchdown passes there. Lastly, let's get out to Jacksonville. See what's happening with the Jaguars at TIAA Bank Field. As you can see the score there in the second quarter, Matthew Stafford has thrown a touchdown pass. We watched a solid performance out of running back DeAndre Swift. He had a touchdown run that helped get his guys this halftime lead.
Okay,
we were certainly
Coach,
treated to an entertaining
always,
first half.
Still
both these teams with some high points and maybe a couple of low points as well.
Three.
So it's going to be a question of who can be the most disciplined team going forward.
And the half will begin with a touchback. This offense ready to go to begin this third quarter. Well, Charles, we saw pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer it.
Now here's a handoff out of the gun. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first
nice
down.
Catch.
Exactly what they did.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That goes for a gain of 31.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely look for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. That's some good hard running there as he'll push his way forward for about 5.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little steps.
There's one more step
to dominate the line of scrimmage.
A field goal would get them the lead, but that's not what they're shooting for as they come up on third down. Back to throw.
Hey, there's the ball. There we go.
Man, that's complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Given the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play. Throwing on first down. Pull.
Let's go.
Wesley. A 14-yard touchdown. And the Huskies have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie.
Because that's why we got big physical wide receivers.
Is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
Elliott Good with a PAT, and the lead is up to five. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth, almost a little bit like a tennis match, right? And we're just, you know, our heads just keep moving. Which side has it? Which side's going to score? How are they going to go out doing it? A little bit of a challenge for each side.
Let's go.
Fit it in on the slant, and it's intercepted. Picked by Ronnie Harrison, and they will set up shop with outstanding field position in the red zone at the 17-yard line. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them. And they took advantage of it there, got a nice interception, and set up their offense in great shape.
On first and 10, Poole. It's complete to Parker, left side. They'll wind up getting just a yard, and that will bring up second down.
1 yard gain brings up second and 9 at the 16-yard line.
Operating from the gun, Poole. Gonna throw right side here, complete. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. Looking to throw, Poole. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. So no gain on the play, and that'll set up second and goal.
At the 6-yard line.
Again, he'll drop to throw.
Let's go.
Allen Robinson from 6 yards away. And the Huskies use the short field to get in for 6. Such an art to dot the I, just get the feet in right there against the line before going out of bounds.
Such an incredibly graceful, athletic play, but also a lot of practice goes into it. They work on that to make sure that they learn how to train their feet to get down in
bounds. Elliott Good on the extra point, and it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
He finds his man complete. That's Hughes. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and that'll bring up second down. Swift going to try up the middle. And some space here. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game.
Here we go.
And space tough to come by there as he'll get maybe a yard to the 37. They work now on 2nd and 9. Once again, it's Swift. And he slips up past the 35 before being tackled.
62 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 16 times.
A couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down.
First down, here's Mitchell. And he's fortunate to get anything from that. Give him a yard up to the 49.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Right back to Mitchell on second down.
And he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43. Give him 8 yards there. Still a few inches to go, though, as it'll be third down at about the length of the football.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have a Giants first down, maybe by about a yard, as they find a way to convert on third and inches.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moved.
And they're right there in the middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up.
Ball on the 36 now. Here's a second and 5. Now Lawrence to throw.
His throw incomplete.
Another attempt, another incompletion. And when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points. And the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
And this one is no good. He missed it.
Let's go.
Listen, now, no kick from 50-plus is a gimme, but here you're indoors in a dome. You'd think ideal conditions.
That kick is getting fired. He missed 3 kicks in 1 game.
Not just us expecting him to make it.
Shooting with extra points.
My theory is very simple. The athletic ability of kickers continues to get better and better. Check their background. They were all county, all state, and other positions, not just soccer players. These guys expect themselves to be great as well.
Well, here's a good way to kick off a drive, complete over the middle. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. So from the 36 now, first and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, second down. From the 34-yard line, here's a second and 8. Operating from the gun.
Come on with these drop passes.
He has just not had his focus in this game. It's not one drop. It's not two. That's 3 for this contest.
Yeah, uncharacteristic for any NFL receiver, and he's no exception.
There you go.
That's complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 20-yard line. A solid gain of 15 yards, and the sticks move.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them, and these guys have been taking advantage so far.
On first down, Poole. It gets it into the arms of Parker, complete. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play, and it'll be second down. Back to throw again. And his throw here is going to be incomplete.
He already came through for them on this drive. No surprise that they were hoping he could do it again.
Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. 3rd and 5. He's going to have the first down and then some. And so close, he gets it to the 1. Out of bounds right there. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Play action. Poole looking in the zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a good flash.
Give them some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground, and now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
They'll try to run this one in, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a 3rd down.
I thought they were onto something with their play call and kind of went in reverse a little bit. Threw it on 1st down,
then ran it on second down. Not successful either way. What play call do they come up with here on this important third down try?
Being chased, and he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown.
Let's go.
Taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Huskies get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that lead. They were looking to pass the ball there, but they forgot to account for the man with the football.
Yeah, I can hear people right now saying, well, why don't you have a spy in your defense, someone who will dance with him and go where he goes? Well, oftentimes, if you utilize a spy, you've taken away someone in coverage as well. And oftentimes, the spy, not as athletic as the guy he's trying to keep up with, so he gets defeated anyway.
And he turns third and goal into a touchdown. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do or die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive,
we should have punched that ball out.
It has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Giants with possession of the football but needing points as we start quarter number four. On first and 10, it's Lawrence. He's got Renfrow on the out route. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. From midfield now, Lawrence. This one into the hands of Pitts.
Oh, God.
And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Kyle Pitts, 50 yards. And the Giants have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth.
For a big tight end, he can sure move like a slot receiver when he gets a head of steam going. And as a defensive back, you've got a big decision to make when he's moving like that.
Sly on for the extra point. And the third time's a charm as he finally gets one of these to go. So a 75-yard scoring drive on just three plays. And it was the tight end Kyle Pitts finishing it all off on the touchdown reception. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. Well, the Rio offense about to set up shop once again. This game was really a tussle, seemed like just a moment ago, and now they've got the momentum. A couple of scores on their last pair of drives, and a two-score lead. I think here now you go conservative, right? Run the football, work the clock.
You know, I usually agree with you, but I'm going after them right here.
Really?
I want to put this bad boy away. I wouldn't be afraid to throw it. They've got all the confidence, all the momentum on their side. Go ahead and take your dagger shots and try and finish this one off.
I disagree vehemently. I say run the football. You've got the lead.
Well, let's watch it and find out who's right.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 58 yards rushing for him now as his fine rookie season continues. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
At the 40-yard line.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw.
No.
He's got his man on the comebacker. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. He has a first down, and that catch will also put him over 100 yards receiving now on the afternoon. Well, normally you might say start running the football. You've got the lead here in the fourth quarter, but the way that they've passed it with such success, I don't know, maybe keep throwing it.
Yeah, I think you brought up something that goes against conventional wisdom, right? In this stage of the game, you would think you would switch to a running attack, but you're exactly right. They've thrown it so well throughout the game, and trusting this quarterback, I think he continued to do so.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Following the penalty, they'll go back to the run game. And a good physical run that time. He's going to wind up gaining 5 on that one. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up 2nd down. And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And down to the 36-yard line here. Give him 9 there. They still need 6 more now on 3rd down. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. To throw on 3rd down. Poole. Man open is Robinson. And they're going to have another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Giants 19. It's a pickup of 16 there that'll lead to a new set of downs. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. Operating from the gun. Poole. And he's got it.
Go.
Touchdown. Devontae Parker from 19 yards away. And the Huskies add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week. Boy, he has been fun to watch throwing the football in this one. And certainly not fun for that defense, though, Charles. Now up to 4 touchdown passes in this ball game.
Yeah, we're supposed to be neutral, but I'm feeling their pain right now because he has absolutely carved up the secondary. A clinic on how to attack a defense and take them out of the game.
Elliott Good with a PAT, and that will make this a 19-point game. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. The New York set to take the field. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. They were just out personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
Now Lawrence, he's going to get that to Swift underneath. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets in territory. So on the other side of the field now, it's 1st and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. And now they're in the hurry up. Throwing again here, it's Lawrence. Over the middle, Amari Cooper, it's complete. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Throwing now, Lawrence on 1st down. He's going to find and complete it to Renfro. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And they'll throw on 1st down with Lawrence. And he's going to go down. He's sacked back in the 24. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on 2nd and 16. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
And he is going to be stopped at the 12, short of the 1st down. Here we go. Got to have it. Lawrence. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Giants go on 4th, but come up empty. And as a result, possession switches hands. Well, their first 4th down attempt earlier was successful. This one backfires for a turnover on downs.
I like their aggressiveness. I like what they're doing. They got it the first time they went for it. Why not a 2nd time? I don't think they'll be daunted from attempting it again. If you're on the defensive side of the ball, though, any 4th down stop is a big momentum play.
Come on.
A full start backs them up 5, 1st and 15. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's up past the 10 to about the 12. It's a 5-yard pickup, so essentially they get the penalty yardage back, and it's back to 2nd and 10. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he'll get this one up to about his 14. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's 3rd down. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. on third down. Pull. And that is incomplete.
That is certainly one way to frustrate a quarterback. Run those extra defenders on the field. Dime package. Lots of speed. No space.
That was a terrible.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Taking up the mix. It'll be a 48-yard punt. Five there on the return. And we have reached the two-minute warning. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 41-yard line. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And this will be scooped up by the defense. And he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line.
Go.
And they'll run the option to start the drive. And holding it may be the wrong decision as he stopped in the backfield. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. And not a lot of success to be found there.
Oh, you got that right, partner, because if you're trying to make guys miss about 10 yards or so downfield, that's a pretty good play. But if you've got to do it in your own backfield, I consider that a problem. That doesn't work too well.
And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. And they'll keep leaning on the running game back to the ground. And they'll bring him down right at midfield, and he is well short of the first down. 4 yards on the pickup there, but it's going to take him to fourth down. Here's A.J. Cole now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. Now, somebody lit a fire under that offense during the break, Charles. Remember, they trailed.
Let's go.
They come out, they have the big second half, and that lifts them to the victory.
And, Brandon, trailing at halftime, we always talk about teams making adjustments. You know what the best adjustments usually are? It's just executing better. Because the game plan you put in place at the beginning of the week often still holds. You don't have to make wholesale changes. Just have to do it a little bit better, a little cleaner. And they did that in the second half, and that led them to victory.
So for Rio, they get win number 10 on the year as they move to 10-1. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for the Giants, it's a loss that'll drop them back to 500 through 10 games. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. So for our entire crew, alongside...
on a roll right now. Colts and Huskies, let's go. We are killing the competition in passing. We're killing them in terms of receiving yards. Gotta get our stacks up. I intercept. Coming along pretty good. All right, I'm gonna leave this here. I want to thank everyone that stopped by. I want to say give a special thanks to the John Slate. Yes, you have to say the, just like a pen name. I appreciate you. I want to give a shout out to Arthendahl. I appreciate talking. Both of these people stream. You could, I appreciate. Thank you. I should be back tomorrow, or maybe this again. I'm not sure, but either way, I would be up on Twitter. I appreciate.